friends, welcome to my channel Home Cooking. Today we are going to make a mother of biscuit. Basically, it is known as Bhakhri. Yesterday, we'll try it our hands, our magic hands, into a terracotta vessels, a pan like this. This will be perfect to replace a bread for your breakfast or tiffin box when you have a very urgency to quick prepare the recipe, yet healthy, tasty and perfect with the jam, marmalade and other kind of sauces or chutneys. So let's get started.
Isn't it looking so amazing and tempting? This is perfect to have it with the hot tea or coffee, and for breakfast, a perfect for tiffin as well. Looking at the texture, this is crispier from outside. The crust is very crispy and a softer from the center. So we'll start our bhakhri with kneading our dough first. I have taken 1.5 whole wheat flour, 1.5 cup. In goes salt to taste and 1.5 tablespoon of oil. I have also taken 1/2 glass of water. First, we will mix all our dry ingredients together with the help of our hands. This is the consistency we are looking for the dough, so that the oil is perfectly added to our dough. In goes a slight water. In bhakhri dough, basically we need a coarse dough, so we don't have the dough like roti or paratha or chapatis. With the help of two hands, once the moisture is perfect getting inside the bhakhri and we feel that we can just make a dough with our hands, that is the correct time you have to stop adding water. This dough will approximately make 3 bhakhris out of it with the help of a rolling pin. As you can see, we will roll our bhakhris, but first I have taken the dough in my hands, and with the help of two hands, with the help of a little pressure of my palm, we will roll our dough and try to make it into a circular mode. It is okay while rolling also, you can make this dough. Now the corners of the bhakhri will always be cracked, and that is the perfect sign that your bhakhri is going into correct direction, and you will also get the same result as mine: crispier crust and a soft from the center, little chewier one. I'm sure after looking at this bhakhri, you will never think of a bread. This is super easy. Now with the help of a fingertip, we'll just give the impression. This is again optional. Usually this is made in a Gujarati family, a very authentic breakfast recipe I'm showing out here. Another technique of rolling bhakhri is, first we will just roll the small amount of dough, we will flip it to the other side, and all the edges and the corners we will bring it into the center, and then change the direction, press it with both our hands, and you get a circular dough ready to just roll it. This way you don't have to worry about the dry dough coming out. For more yummy, amazing and healthy recipes like this, do log on to my channel and don't forget to subscribe it. We will seal the cracked edges like the earlier bhakhri. With the help of our fingertips, we will give the impressions. Our second bhakhri is also done rolling. Now time comes to the third bhakhri. As the dough is dry, I have added 1 teaspoon of water, started kneading our dough, and then slightly pressed it with the help of both the fingers and rolling it. Now as you can see, it's a big crack. Don't panic, overlap it, press it, and your third bhakhri is ready. It is such a simple and easy recipe, guys. Do try it at your home and let me also know into the comments. Now the impression side of the bhakhri comes down and the flat part comes up. After 1 minute, you will check your bhakhri. I have kept it into the medium flame with the help of the corner of butter knife. We will lift our bhakhri with one hand. As you can see, the corners are raw. I will put that raw corners into the center and let it roast for another few seconds. Once it's done, I'll roast put it into the other part. Once that is also done in few seconds, I will flip it. You can see the brown is over here. That says your bhakri is cooked very nicely. This is also cooked. This is the third time I will flip it. Gently press it so that every corners of bhakri gets crispier. We will slow the flame and check whether our bhakri is perfect. Now you can see the crispier edges of the bhakri, and the bhakri is done roasting. It's time to add a lovely generous amount of ghee, as much as you want. I have just added 1 teaspoon, as I eat that much only in bhakri. We will press it and you can feel the crispier part so that the ghee reaches inside. And the same way I have roasted all the bhakris. It's my favorite part of serving. I have served this with the hot tea. Let me know what you would like to serve with this bhakri into the comment section.
Thank you for watching this amazing recipe of bhakri. Do log on to my channel for more amazing and tempting videos. But don't forget to subscribe, share with your friends, and also give your comments into the feedback. It means a lot to me. Don't forget to just click the thumbs up. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.